You're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I got the tapes that you sent me, Liz, and a few of you others who sent me tapes from December the 31st. And I have been doing exactly what I told you I was going to do. I've been going through them today, and I was going to... I was going to edit a big long tape of, and it's difficult. I've got to tell you, there is so much fear mongering and so many inaccurate reporting and all kinds of stuff that it's hard. So what we're going to do is we're just going to make the rest of this week a series of this stuff, and tonight's going to sort of set the stage. You'll discover if you were listening last night why what you're going to hear tonight is so important. These are just short snippets of the Alex Jones Show from New Year's Eve, December the 31st. This is news. This is news, ladies and gentlemen. What you're going to hear here, what he's saying is deception. It's fear-mongering. It scared the hell out of literally millions of people, and it got worse later. You're not even going to hear the worst part. You're just going to hear the beginning, because what you're going to hear tonight is just taken from the first 45 minutes of his broadcast. His broadcast on December the 31st, New Year's Eve. These are just little snippets taken from the first 45 minutes of the Alex Jones Show. I didn't take everything that was scary, because we don't have time to do that if we're going to talk about it. But I took just little snippets from the first 45 minutes, and his broadcast, I think, is 3 hours long. And it gets a lot worse as time goes on. You can hear the fear and the excitement and the adrenaline in Alex Jones's voice later on. You're not going to hear so much of that in the early stages of the broadcast. And then he goes on later on the Midas report with Michael Trudeau, and it totally gets out of hand. What you're going to hear is a build-up, and then later. And this is what makes me think that the whole thing was staged, because this buildup sets the stage for a full-blown panic across the country later. And you'll hear about that either tomorrow night or Thursday. But you're going to hear it, because this is just absolutely incredible. So stay tuned, folks. And be careful. You'll probably get scared. I mean, just listening to this stuff on New Year's Eve, December the 31st, I had the Genesis Communications Radio Network patched through 101.1 FM, because I wanted the people in the valley to hear what everybody else in the country was hearing, and they don't get anything here but music. That's all they get, honestly, including mine, except for the Hour of the Time. So I wanted them to hear what everybody else in the nation was hearing, so that if there was a full-blown panic, they'd know why, because I knew these people were going to build everybody up into a lather. And the reason, you know, I got to tell you, folks, there's times when law enforcement and government agencies and things like that are needed. And if these guys had succeeded, if they had actually succeeded in whipping up a hysteria that would have caused a large segment of the population to panic and riot in the streets, and I think this may be what they were trying to create. I don't know this for sure, but you'll see, as we go through these three nights, and you hear the build-up to what could have been an absolute catastrophe. And it all came from these people. And it's just absolutely incredible. I mean, people really went off the deep end. A lot of people got scared. Some people got sick. A lot of people headed, literally, for the hills. just from listening to these guys. This is not a joke. I'm not kidding you. It really happened, just exactly as I've described. So stay tuned. You're going to hear it all. It's incredible, too. Right, folks, I'm your man. The only thing you ever get from the Hour of the Time is the truth. Now, I want you to understand that this little series that we're doing is nothing personal against Alex Jones or anybody else. But I happen to know for a fact, absolute fact, and listen to me very carefully, that people who practice this kind of broadcasting and claim to be an American patriot do nothing but discredit all of us eventually. It's wrong. It is absolutely wrong. This guy would take a call, and some caller would report something, and instead of saying, well, we're not, you know, like I do on this broadcast, when somebody calls in and starts, wants to tell a rumor, I tell them, no, we don't do that on this broadcast. If you want to call me tomorrow, I'll check it out, and if it turns out to be true, and the listening audience needs to hear, then we'll make arrangements for you to call in, and it can be your story, and we'll do it. But that's the only way it's done on this broadcast. All of these other people, they take phone calls. And a lot of these phone calls are people spreading rumors. And these rumors, 99% of them, turn out to be wrong. And it's wrong to allow that to happen. Especially when the host takes it and runs with it. Without any checking, without any calling, without any research, without anything. This is one of the people who pulls faxes off the fax machine and reads them over the air. This is the one of people who indiscriminately reads Associated Press wire reports and ABC wire reports and news releases and press releases without checking them out. Associated Press, UPI, especially ABC, have been well known to plant fake, phony, and false stories. We've all discovered that over the years. No radio host who reports the news, especially on a day when he knows that a good segment of the population is afraid, that we've been told to expect the collapse of civilization as we know it, and all kinds of things like that, to participate in this kind of fear-mongering. Listen very carefully, folks. This will frost you, and then we'll talk about it. I may stop the tape at certain portions, and we'll talk about it then. Listen very carefully. This is just snippets taken from the first 45 minutes of the Alex Jones show on December the 31st, New Year's Eve. This is news. What I'm reporting here to you is hard news. This could have resulted in the shutdown of the whole country, the declaration of martial law, mass hysteria and panic by millions of people. And this is the guy, along with a few others, but this is the main guy who was whipping it all up. Listen carefully.
cash machines are failing in Britain and now other European countries. They're finding large amounts of explosives in France. Vladimir Putin, who is known as Vladimir the Ruthless, and using all his profanity on national TV, you name it. We won't read the profanity here, but we've got it. This person is on an unbelievable power trip and resembles a demon. He is a creature of the IMF and the World Bank and international communism. He is a former KGB head, and this information is vital, ladies and gentlemen. We are seeing the New World Order really come out in full force. More wars than have been in the last 50 years are going on right now. The war in Chechnya is raging in Grozny with reports of hundreds of thousands dying.
Is that true, folks? Are there more wars going on right now than in the last 50 years? Are there hundreds of thousands of people dying right now in Chechnya? Listen to this. This man is just making it up right out of his head as he goes along.
According to 40,000 civilians trapped in the city, Russian Hinds are being shot down, tanks are being blown to bits, massive Grad unguided rocket attacks are being launched from the city indiscriminately right now, air and artillery bombardments as well. It's absolutely out of control. It is pandemic, ladies and gentlemen. I'll give you the news first on Y2K, the newest developments. The Pennsylvania nuclear plant has been shut down. One of the main systems transferring the power from it failed, but they say it's not a Y2K problem. And the things I'm experiencing here in Austin, Texas, the shelves are empty of water and some gas stations are running out of fuel. Here in Central Texas and in Minneapolis, Minnesota, the shortwave is basically down, ladies and gentlemen. Went off right as I went on the air. The big news on Y2K. Then we'll start going to your calls. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. All right, let's go ahead and get to this article. Associated Press, this came out at 7:22 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Today, December 31st, 1999, Pennsylvania nuclear plant shut down one of the two nuclear reactors at PECO Energy Co.'s Limerick Generating Station has shut down this morning after a piece of equipment failed. Company spokesman Neil McDermott said the problem was not Y2K related. It was declared an unusual event, the least serious emergency classification of a nuclear power plant. They got to have a serious emergency to shut down a plant, ladies and gentlemen. You power one down, you're not going to power it up for at least days. It was declared an unusual event. At 2:55 a.m., shutdown occurred when an insulator on the main generator transformer from Limerick 2 failed. We had reports yesterday of this. Off the record, I would not report it, but I had it from a good source that this plant was having problems along with four other plants. I may just go ahead and report it here. Boy, do we get good information here. This has been going on for days. From our information, it is not this transformer that they're talking about. They wouldn't just shut a plant down over that. Something serious may be going on there. So that the central government, known as the federal government, the occupational government in Washington, D.C., has set up a huge $50 million command bunker hooked into all the FEMA boxes that can take over all the shortwave broadcast and commercial AM and FM stations, as well as television broadcast stations. And we hope they do not activate that. Ladies and gentlemen, police and military are on high alert, running around looking for supposed boogeymen and terrorists under every rock. Military are highly visible now. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, there are trains of military equipment moving into Austin. Two nights ago, on Wednesday night, Fox News reported that the airport will be used as a massive holding facility for troublemakers or rioters here in Austin that has no history of riots. They need to get that country locked down so they can stage the election for Vladimir Putin. I mean, this guy is a demon. Have you seen this guy? It's just how he's raging with power. I'm Alex Jones. I'm your host. I'm just one of the great hosts here on the GCN Radio Network, and I've been very passionate today because I can't even keep track of all the developing news as it's coming in. I'm not going to get into that. I'm not even going to say it's 6 to 7 reactors across the country. I'm not even going to. It's bad, and I got this news about the Pennsylvania plant early yesterday, got it again off air, confirmed it with someone that is 99% accurate, about like I am, trying to report the truth, and now I've got the Associated Press saying, well, they shut the whole plant down, but they call it an unusual event, the least serious emergency classification of a nuclear power plant. Well, it's got to be pretty bad for them to power a plant down.
Time is getting shorter until Y2K. If you want to be sure your family and loved ones weather the potential Y2K storm of delays, shortages, or interruptions of services, then now is the time to stock up on emergency supplies and a home food reserve.
As the developments move forward with this Y2K and this gear up for clamping down America and Russia and around the world by globalist forces, we'll be bringing you the news as long as we're here on the air. Now pretty much dictator and controller of Russia publicly, and here in America they're gearing up and bracing for terrorism and militarizing everything in front of us. So it's happening there, it's happening here. There they're using the war with Chechnya. Here they're using Y2K and the threat of terrorism. Oh, this is extremely serious. 2 weeks ago, Topol M, 6,200-mile super-range, multiple warhead, newest design, U.S. clone technology missiles were deployed across Russia. They're mobile. These are first-strike-type systems. They're also designed to survive several strikes from America or any other nation. They're deploying these, and Yeltsin openly has been threatening us weekly to nuke us. I mean, it's just getting insane. And absolutely, this looks like just one more ratchet on the takeover of America. And yes, they have an extreme strongman in KGB leader running Russia right now. They have deployed their missiles against us and their submarines and have already delivered fully functional missile cruisers to China. Yes, he took the codes off and he took away our first strike capability. By first strike, that means if missiles are in the air, mm-hmm. let's say 4,000 of them. Russians have got a lot more than that.
Right.
4,000 missiles coming in, subs launching, suitcases going off. We have to wait until we absorb the first strike. That will mean virtual annihilation to our military. Brass, I know you're CFR. You've been told you'll be able to be in the bunker if they go to this level. I don't know if they'll do it. It may just be ratcheting down the global system. All I know is this. Boris Yeltsin, at 4 o'clock in the morning, as the Russian time zone in its eastern area near Japan was entering into Y2K, he resigned, and now Vladimir Putin, known as Vladimir the Ruthless by the Russian people, is now taking the reins of power, supreme power in Russia, and he is a former KGB chief.
There's something else I want to tell you, Alex.
Well, hold on just a second. Okay. I mean, this is extremely serious. Again, I was getting this information, what you just said, 2 days ago, and I got it even more. I ignored it then I got it yesterday, and now it's in the Associated Press that in Pennsylvania, where you're calling from, in the city you're calling from, one of two nuclear reactors at PECO's Energy Co. Limerick Generating Station was shut down this morning after a piece of equipment failed. And they're saying it's non-Y2K related. This is just unbelievable.
One other thing. I heard Bo Greig say this morning that Russia said if their power goes out that they're going to blame us and they're going to set off their nuclear warheads.
Well, I didn't hear that, but I would be interested to have any details. Do you have the details of what Colonel Greig said?
No, that's all I heard him say was that they said if they had a power blackout, they'd blame it on us.
I know they're threatening to nuke us every single week. I've read the Associated Press, Reuters, Interfax News Agency, London Times articles here. I mean, I read Yeltsin and Jiang Zemin's quotes, the dictator of China, and they're saying, we'll nuke you. I mean, they spell it out. We will hit you with nuclear weapons. We reserve the right to hit you. 3 weeks ago, their head of other missile forces said, we reserve the right to nuke you first. Their currency is plunging. The Egyptian pound is plunging against the dollar. The Japanese yen, the Deutsche Mark, and the just all of it. It's and the same thing is starting to develop here in America. Many of the gas stations here in Austin have the little gloves over the pumps saying they're out of fuel. You never see this in Austin, Texas. Right here in South Austin, I've seen several stations. We don't know if this is just a Y2K that was here. Just bizarre behavior. Americans standing up as Russia threatens to attack us with nuclear weapons, as nuclear power plants, at least one, are being shut down, as the military runs around with the police and the FBI saying terrorism is imminent, and some would characterize us as dangerous because we report the facts. Absolutely out of control. Just maintain your readiness, be calm, defend your family, defend your country, but doing a fabulous job. He is consulting with people that he knows personally, a lot of former military people that now own radio companies, and in fact, I'm not even going to say who the individual is. I'm sure he could call it publicly. I just don't want to give a lot of folks' names out on the air. They have activated a powerful Cold War radar system in the North Pole region. That is something that is grounding out shortwave. The entire 9400 band, all throughout the 9.4000 up to 9.9. I mean, they are. The military traffic is everywhere right now, ladies and gentlemen. Scrambled. We've got superpower radar systems, nuclear systems up, and perhaps our military is refused. It was Clinton that shut down that Cold War radar system. It's now back up from people that actually worked in there. We have it confirmed from the sound and where it's coming from experts. Fresno, where our servers are located, is in the middle of a blackout. Ladies and gentlemen, we're off the Internet. This is just absolutely out of control. That's why the commercial stations are so important. More information coming at you on the other side as Y2K develops.
Many of you have been preparing for the worst of times, putting away storable foods and water. While this makes perfect sense, we at Midas Resources urge you to consider the possibility of having to flee for your lives. Though the very prospect of this sounds grim, the possibilities are more than remote. Asian countries now having long-range nuclear bombs, a politically unstable Russia, and an increasing presence of NATO here on U.S. soil could spark a ground war in the West.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Bringing you continuing, unfiltered, unabashed reality. I am Alex Jones. I am your host.
And I'm William Cooper, and I'm your non-fear-mongering, truthful host. When we come back, we're going to open the phone, 520-333-4578, 520-333-4578, and we'll talk about what you just heard.
There is a war between the ones who say there is a war and the ones who say there is war. What's going to come back? I guess he called it love, I call it room service.
To the hour of the time. I'm William Cooper. The phones are open, 520-333-4578. Let me take your calls. And the first thing I want to talk about is what is he trying to instill in his audience here? With what you've heard, what is he trying to make the audience feel? 520-333-4578. This is all very important, folks. You'll find out in the next couple of days where this goes. And when you find out where it goes, if you weren't listening on December the 31st, you're going to be shocked, because it has the smell of a setup. It has the total smell of a setup. 520-333-4578 is the number. Where do you think he's leading his audience? What do you think he's instilling in his audience with what you've heard during that during those short snippets? And remember, that's the only snippets from the first 45 minutes of the broadcast on December the 31st, New Year's Eve. There's still 2 hours and 15 minutes to go. Can you believe it? 2 hours and 15 minutes to go, and he's already set the stage for something very serious that's going to happen later. 520-333-4578. What did it make you feel like? How did you, if it was December the 31st, New Year's Eve again, and you knew that at the stroke of midnight, everybody was expecting everything to come to a grinding halt because of Y2K, what would this have made you feel like? What would be your emotional state right now, if you, you know, if you were to have an emotional state? The number is 520-333-4578. Good evening, you're on the air.
Yeah, Bill, I'll just chime in with this. You figure that the Austin, Texas area used to be Jim Hightower country, right?
Uh-huh.
And it's a town in Texas, which, you know, Texas is a relatively conservative so-called state. But I think that Metro Austin is a pretty liberal bastion.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Right? It's sort of like...
far left-wing.
Yeah, it's like Madison, Wisconsin South.
Yeah.
And so you figure, you know, when I realized that there was a lot of, like, grassroots libertarian type stuff happening in that town, it just made sense to me that the feds, given what was going on with the Republic of Texas thing, were definitely going to focus on that area and probably try to whip things up.
Oh, boy, did they ever.
And then, you know, Alex Jones was associated with this guy who was, what was his name? It was the same name as the fella who was the president of the Confederacy. Jeff Davis.
Uh-huh.
And I looked at that name and I said, is this guy's name really Jeff Davis? Did his mama call him that? Or did he take on this name to give patriotic people the whiff of, you know, the Confederacy and bigotry?
Sure, you're on the right trail.
Yeah. So, you've done a good job exposing him. Look forward to listening to the rest of the tape.
No, wait a minute. What did that make you feel when you were listening to that?
Well, the same, you know... I've listened to enough, you know, Bo Greif's broadcast to get a feel for that type of stuff. Yeah, they're definitely, you know, whipping people up. I can't imagine who is so gullible who, you know, can get swept up with that, but I guess there's people out there.
Yeah, but what do you think he was specifically preparing you to think? Did you get the whole gist of what he was talking about there?
I guess I fail to get what you're driving at. Beyond what I've said.
What was the main thing that he concentrated on?
That Russia was imminently going to attack the continental United States.
You got it. That we were going to be nuked by Russia.
Right.
He spent 45 minutes of the first hour preparing his radio audience to believe that Russia was going to nuke us because of Y2K.
Right.
And guess what happened much later? Well, never mind. Let it be a surprise.
Okay, I haven't heard it before, so I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, this was a setup from the word go. This guy is not on our side. He's right. A commercial broadcaster, number one. And number two, he was never a member of the Patriot movement at all. All of a sudden, he started picking this stuff up and just running with it.
Well, let me get a dig in, Bill. Captain Conspiracy, if you're out there, Dutch told you so. Thank you.
Well, it's true, folks.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks for calling.
Yeah.
Number is 520-333-4578. What did you think about it? There's a lot of people out there sitting there scratching your heads. You heard it. I played it for you right here. You heard it. What did you think about it? If you were listening to that on December the 31st, 1999, how would that make you feel? What would be going through your mind? What would you be thinking about? Hello? Anybody home? Or have you all just had a total migration of your brain power? You know what I'm talking about out there. And you know me, folks. I'm not in a popularity contest. I don't give a damn what anybody thinks about me. I only care about the truth, period. The truth. And it's about time some of you got acquainted with the real hard truth. What was going on New Year's Eve was whipping the American people up into a hysteria, trying to make them do something that would justify martial law. That's why the military and the federal agencies and the FBI and everybody was all geared up and ready to go. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hey, Bill.
Yeah.
This is Matt from Florida. How are you?
Good.
Yeah, I think that guy, he was just trying to scare people and get them into a panic.
Oh, that was just the beginning, and that's not even, he hasn't even started yet.
Mm-hmm.
That's just the first 45 minutes of a three-hour broadcast, and he's just beginning to get warmed up.
Mm-hmm. Well, I haven't been listening to shortwave too much lately. I've been mostly tuned into the internet and the press. I used to listen to WWCR back around 93, 94, 96, and you hear some of the same kind of things back then. For some of these people, but probably not so much like the Y2K crowd.
Well, you see, the government knows they can't pull another Waco.
Mm-hmm.
They got to try and get us to do something to justify what they want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And everything that was happening on December the 31st on the Genesis Communications Radio Network and many others was all trying to whip up the American people to do something stupid so that they could actually declare martial law and start rounding people up.
Mm-hmm. I've been making preparations for quite some time as far as food storage and weapons training and some of that kind of stuff. But that's mainly just for just whatever happens to come down the pike,
not specifically
for Y2K.
Just hang loose, you should always be prepared for any emergency. But
I've been making my preparations since before Y2K became too hyped up, you know.
Oh, I was telling people to get prepared to stock up on 2 years of food storage and water and guns and ammunition, everything 8 years ago.
Yeah, well.
In fact,
I've got myself a year and a half supply of food, so I thought that was pretty good.
Yeah, well, that's great. You're going to need it one of these days.
Uh-huh.
But you don't ever let anybody whip you up into making it happen. Remember, we must have the moral high ground. So we have to wait for them to do something that justifies acting, restoration by the militia of the lawful constitutional Republican government of this country.
The side that fires the first shot will probably lose public opinion, and if they don't have public opinion,
absolutely,
they'll probably lose the war.
That's right. Sure. Whoever fires the first shot loses. I've said that since 1989. I've been telling people that, and it's the truth. And if they fire the first shot and the militia moves against them legitimately and lawfully to restore constitutional Republican government and they bring the military against us, the entire American population will support us.
Yeah.
But if we fall into these traps that these people were laying on December the 31st, forget it. It's all over.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. Well, I'll let you go.
Okay, thanks for calling.
Good evening. Bye-bye.
Thank you. 520-333-4578 is the number. This is like high school, see. You know, I just slammed the popular guy in the senior class, rightfully so, and I let you know what this guy is really doing, and you're all scared to death to get on the phone and talk about it. Just like high school. Which brings me back to something else I've always said. America's nothing but a bunch of little chicken cowards. The vast American population, most of them, are cowards. And that's why you all file and pay your income tax, even though none of you can find a law that requires you to do it. Isn't that right, folks? Isn't that true? And here, you know, that's something else. Do you ever ask Alex Jones if he files and pays income tax? Good evening, you're on the air.
Hey, Bill, it's Monty from Radio Free Vermont.
Hi, Monty.
Hey, it's basically just to stir up the people.
Yeah.
Get them all whipped up into a frenzy.
Uh-huh.
And then get them to take action.
Yeah.
Upon that frenzy.
Oh, they almost succeeded. I mean, people really went off the deep end. And you'll hear what sparked that later. You'll hear that either tomorrow night or Thursday night. But they actually got to that point where they panicked. Large numbers of people actually were heading for the hills. Really?
It's sick, because the one thing that we need the least is a revolution.
Yep.
We're not going to like what comes out of it. It may not turn out the way we want it to turn out. It may turn just the opposite.
Revolution, you never know what the outcome of a revolution will be. But a restoration, that's something different. We all know what the outcome is going to be. We know what the goal is, to restore constitutional Republican government, to do away with the excesses in government, to arrest those who have subverted this country and destroyed it, and hold them until they can be tried by a jury of their peers, as the Constitution dictates, and find out if they're innocent or guilty.
I agree. I mean,
and if they're guilty, hang them.
Lenin said that socialism was brought about through revolution.
Yeah.
And that's what these people are trying to do. Basically.
They're trying to instigate the American people to rise up against the government to justify changing the entire character of this nation and bring about one world totalitarian socialist government.
Yeah.
That's what they're doing.
Now, Bill, is it just my imagination, or has that network been the same network that Mark Cornkey has had that's gone through, what, 3 or 4 different changes of name and etc.?
No, I don't think so. Mark Cornkey and John Stadtmiller started out with their own network, and that became Truth Radio Network.
Right.
And Stadtmiller does have a show on Genesis Communications Network, but Truth Radio Network is something entirely different.
Because it all seems to me sometimes, I remember back in listening to Shortwave a couple years ago, it was always the same voices, different names, always.
Yeah.
The same players in the play,
yeah,
just different character names.
Sure.
So,
and you're
of the same.
Yeah, and you'll never find anybody like me on any network like that, because they certainly don't want the American people to really know what the truth is.
No. Well, I'll let you go.
Okay. Thanks for calling. Or anybody like you, Monty. 520-333-4578. Monty runs Radio Free Vermont, which carries this broadcast and other good broadcasting. He does his own broadcasting in Vermont. He has successfully whipped the butt of the FCC when he did exactly what I told him to do. See, the argument with the FCC is never freedom of speech or anything else like that. It's always jurisdiction. And if you stick to jurisdiction and you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, they can't win. It's absolutely impossible. Unless they stand up openly in front of the entire world and rip the Constitution to shreds. If they do that, then they can win anything they want to do, because they can make their own rules, which, you know, they do whenever they can. Good evening, you're on the air.
Yes, Bill, good evening. First, I'd like to say this live feed on the Internet is a great thing.
Well, thank you.
I mean, I haven't been able to get you on the shortwave, so...
Yeah, you can thank Scott Becker for that live Internet
feed.
Oh,
yeah, I thank them every night. reason why I'm calling, being I live here in New Jersey, kind of reminds me of something that happened, I guess, what, 40, 50 years ago, when there was a radio broadcast that supposedly we were being invaded from Mars.
Oh, yeah.
In the War of the Worlds.
Uh-huh.
And it pretty much terrorized the metropolitan area here.
It did.
People were shooting at water towers and...
Yeah.
And
what was the name of the city in New Jersey that was featured in
that? Was it Grover's Mill?
Yeah, Grover's Mill. Yeah. All the people in Grover's Mill forgot they even had a water tower. They came out with their guns, and they saw their water tower in the night, in the moonlight, in the starlight, and they thought it was one of the alien tripod machines, and they shot their own city water tower full of holes.
Right. And from just listening to that 45-minute clip, it just brought me back to remember listening to that show. And it just amazed me that people just don't look out their own window to see what's actually going on.
Well, I don't think they care. I think they want something to be going on.
I
think they're waiting for somebody to tell them what to do. I think they're waiting for somebody to whip them up and get their adrenaline going and make fools out of them.
But, you know, some people want that, though.
I know they do.
And
they're called stupid sheeple.
Because I was, I worked on aircraft, and that night I was working. And matter of fact, I was actually using the HF radio that he said was not working, because we do time checks all the time, and that's at 10.00, and I just wanted to listen to the universal coordinated time to wait for the actual real midnight, which. Most of the industry used, which was 7 o'clock Eastern Time.
Yeah. How'd you like the way he was whipping up the Christians by calling Putin a demon? Putin is just a human being that happens to live in the Soviet Union and has risen to some position of prominence. We may not like his politics.
Exactly.
We may not like his philosophy, but he's just a man like everybody else. He is not a demon.
Well, he was just a person just to put on a pedestal for everybody to fear.
Oh, Cornelius Jones, he's a demon! He's a demon!
I'd like to put some of my balls in the work and make them demons, too. You know? That I'm sure to be worse.
Yeah.
All right, Bill. I'll get off the air for somebody else to call.
Thanks for calling.
Thanks, bye.
520-333-4578 is the number. If you got any guts, call us up. Let us know what you think about it. If you disagree, call up and let us know what you think about it. Not too many people do that, though. They don't know how to participate in the real argument. People think that an argument is yelling at each other. An argument is two people taking opposing sides in a conversation. And why it's called an argument is because each one has to support their side with facts in a decent, polite, intelligent exchange of ideas. That's what an argument really is. Good evening. You're on the air.
Oh, Bill, I'm calling from Canada.
Hi.
I can barely hear you here every night. The VOA is wiping you out every night here.
Well...
But I can just barely hear what you're saying, but I listen to Jones every day, and I don't think he's a government agent, but I don't believe most of what he says.
Well, good for you. You shouldn't, because most of what he says is definitely not true.
He was trying to set us up for doomsday.
Yeah.
And, you know, one thing he always talks about every day is that there's Chinese and Russian troops all over the U.S. Have you seen any?
There are no Chinese and Russian troops in the U.S., except those who are on legitimate exchange training programs.
And then another thing he says, that Canadian and Mexican troops are getting ready to invade the U.S.
That's a lie. That's
Can
a bull.
Can you believe this? Canadian.
That's a bull.
We only have a total of about 50,000 troops in our whole military.
Yeah.
We can barely defend our own country.
Yeah. That's a bull. It's just a bull-faced lie. I'm calling him a liar when he says that right now. It's a lie. Canadian troops and Mexican troops are not gearing up to invade the United States of America.
Yeah, well, Mexican, he repeats that every day.
I know, but the Mexican troops have their hands full with the Zapatistas down in southern Mexico, and they sure don't want to tangle with the United States of America, I can guarantee you.
Well, certainly.
They couldn't even beat the... Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
They'd have trouble with the Texas Rangers.
Right.
Now, I'm not saying that the Mexican army is a bad army. They just don't compare with our level of training and technology, and they've never fought major wars like we have. Their training is—they couldn't do it. They just could not do it. They're good, decent people down there in Mexico.
So what does he think they're going to do? Occupy the United States?
Who?
this is ridiculous.
It's a lie. It's just a bold-faced lie. And hold off on that web. See, I don't know if he's a government agent or not, but if he's not a government agent, he was sure duped on December the 31st.
Well, I think he's been duped himself by a lot of this stuff.
Well,
you know,
could be.
He actually believes it.
Wait till you hear later on, either tomorrow night or Thursday night, a general is going to come out and make an announcement that is going to fulfill all of this stuff that he's building people up to
do. Oh, about the missiles being shot off.
Well, we're not going to talk about that yet. We're going to hold that till tomorrow night or Thursday night.
Okay.
And you'll see where this is leading. He builds people up, and then the government delivers the coup de grace. And then he whips up the frenzy, and you can hear the fear and the adrenaline in his voice, and you can tell that these people are panicked.
Right on.
And it causes panic in the population, and people start heading for the hills. They were scared to death.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'll keep listening.
Thanks a lot.
Bye.
520-333-4578 is the number. You know, see, I bet you most of the people who are listening on December 31st don't even have the brains to be able to put all this together and understand that they were set up to be terrorized, to become hysterical, to head for the hills, to do something stupid, and I'm awful glad that that didn't happen. You see, they went overboard. They scared them so bad that they didn't riot. They were trying to dig holes. Good evening. You're on the air.
Oh, Mr. Cooper, it's George in Arkansas.
Hi, George.
I'm glad you've put this all out for everybody to analyze and listen to again. I myself missed it when it was initially on.
Well, you got to do that because people don't think anymore. And see, if I didn't lay this out and let them examine it, they would never even know it occurred, even though they were listening to it and got scared by it all.
Yes, sir. And before anyone realized what was really going on, they would be out in panic mode doing whatever.
Yeah.
And,
well, many of them were, but thank God they didn't riot.
He was also on Tex Mars' show the other night. I had listened to him and spewing the same stuff that he had the other night, and of course promoting his video.
Now he claims that he's always said that Y2K would amount to nothing and nothing would happen. Well, you can see by what you listened to that's not true. He was promoting it, and I listened to his show this morning. He's still saying that everything. What he's doing is pulling all the normal news that normally occurs that nobody ever pays any attention to, and he's blaming every bit of it on Y2K. If a little town loses their power for a few hours, it's Y2K. If a computer goes down in a video rental store, it's Y2K.
It's going to be real amusing how they try and spread this out over the next few months to keep the keep everybody. On the edge of their seat.
Oh, yeah, and they still got all the Y2K commercials going. They're still pulling in the money, and there's still people buying into it.
And then, like you said, 5-5-2000, they'll...
Guess what he said today? And I called the Atomic Energy Commission to find out if it was true. He said that 12 atomic power plants had shut down in this country. He said that 2 had shut down in Japan. Well, I went to high school in Japan. I made some good friends. I know people in Japan. It's not true. They had a computer problem at 2 nuclear power plants in Japan, and the computer problem was with the computer that monitors certain things in the reactor. And a lot of it is monitoring of radiation. They did not shut down the plants, and within just a few hours, they had both of the computers fixed. No atomic power plants were shut down in Japan. I can't find anywhere in the United States where 12 atomic power plants shut down. I can find 3, period.
If 12 were down, I imagine we'd be in a bad state of affairs here.
I found 3, period. The one in Pennsylvania, one in Michigan, and one down south somewhere. I forget exactly where it's at. But they all shut down for normal routine things that go wrong in power plants. You see, when you have machinery and you have technology and you have computers, things go wrong. And you have to sometimes shut down equipment to fix things. And it's not a big catastrophe. You notice how he kept saying in those clips that I was running that they didn't shut down for that power transformer. It had to be something really wrong happened in there. Well, that's a lie. They really did shut down because some insulation in the transformer failed. And they only shut down 1 of 2 reactors that they have because if the reactor is going, they couldn't go in there and work on this piece of equipment that generates the electricity because of the steam pressure.
Yeah.
And they had to shut it down to bleed the system in order to work on it.
As you stated, he's a change agent. He's making it very apparent.
Well, I don't know if he's a change agent. He just might be a dupe. They just might be feeding him this information, and him being such a young man and not understanding how disinformation works, he just might be taking the ball and running with it. He might.
Mouthpiece.
Yeah, he just might be an unwitting agent, is what we call that in the intelligence community.
All right, I thank you for your time.
You're welcome. Thanks for calling.
Yes, sir.
520-333-4578. Amazing. I'm amazed. I am amazed, folks. 520-333-4578. I don't know why he's doing this. I don't know if he's just a dupe or if he really is a change agent. But I'll tell you this. Everything that happened on December the 31st was set up by the government, and everything between these radio stations and what the government was doing was coordinated. Good evening. You're on the air.
Oh, yeah. Hi, Mr. Cooper. This is Virginia in Texas.
Hi.
I just want to let you know I can't hear part of the program tonight. The VOA is blocking it on both sides.
Well, order the tape.
Pardon me?
Order the tape. Sounds like they don't want you to know.
Oh. Yeah, well, I know already. I mean, the only thing I've got to say about that bunch is they keep claiming they're Christians, which they don't demonstrate any evidence of. You know? I mean, I hear them all day long.
That's true. Especially Jackie Petru. She claims to be a Christian.
I know about her, too.
And preaches New Age nonsense.
Pardon me?
And preaches New Age nonsense all day.
Well, none of them fool me. I've been following this bunch for a long time, and none of them fool me whatsoever.
Good for you.
I know what they are. And I didn't hear most of the programming on Saturday because I had to go someplace. But
no, this is Friday we're talking about.
Friday night. Yeah, New Year's Eve, yeah. Yeah, I had to go someplace. But I've heard them before, and yes, there is an accelerated level of, instant panic-type mode.
Yeah.
And it seemed to me, as it sometimes normally does on the frequencies during the daytime, that it's hype. But unless you're an old-time listener, you wouldn't know that.
Or unless you know how to use your brain.
Yes. And I find that there's a lot of new people coming on, and they haven't got a clue about these people.
That's right.
But
they sure don't.
Yeah, I just thought I'd give you a quick call and let you know that you're blocked on both sides tonight by the VOA, and we can hardly hear you at all. So,
well, I'm going to have to talk to Alan Weiner about that because
yeah,
I'm paying for airtime, and if he can't give me a frequency that people that can hear, then I don't pay for airtime when people can't hear me.
Yeah, well, that's why I thought I'd call you and let you know that you're very hardly audible tonight.
Well, thank you.
Okay, Mr. Cooper.
Appreciate it.
Bye bye.
520-333-4578 is the number. We got time for maybe two or three more calls. Yeah, if you can't hear the broadcast, order the tape. 520-333-4578 is the number. This series is going to be priceless. People are going to want this series. And it's important. Oh, by the way, it's January. We have our annual sale in January. I'm going to tell you right now, everything that we have is one-third off. Now, this isn't something we're just coming up with. We've been doing this every year since 1992. Every year since 1992. It's our annual sale in January. For 30 days, everything is one-third off. Everything we have, I don't care what it is. Good evening, you're on the air.
Yeah, Bill, are you? Hello?
Yeah, I'm here.
I've been having real bad reception problems with your...
Don't get into that. We're talking about a topic. There's nothing I can do about it.
Well, it's an interesting topic, but, I just wanted to let you know for the past 2 months...
Call the radio station. There's nothing I can do about it, folks. You just waste air time. This is valuable air time. I want to devote it to something that needs to be said. So if you got something that you want to comment on, fine. But don't call in to give me radio checks. It doesn't do any good. It just wastes their time. There are people listening. No matter how bad the reception may be, there are some people listening who can hear this broadcast. Some of them, you'd be amazed where they are. A lot of them are on the Internet. Did you know on the Internet during this time slot, we are the number one talk show on the Internet. Number one, bar none. 520-333-4578 is... the number. If you got the guts to call and talk to the most dangerous radio host in America, then get on the phone. Good evening, you're on the air.
Hello, Mr. Cooper.
Yes, sir.
I'm calling from Australia.
Oh, well, good. Hi.
Yeah, and I've been listening to the Patriot Networks over the Internet for probably about 3 or 4 years.
Uh-huh.
And often they say things which, like here in Australia, like, living here, we know better than you guys over there.
Oh, they say a lot of things about Australia that are not true, don't they?
Yeah, like U.S. military kicking in doors to search for guns over here.
I know, I remember that when I exposed it as bullshit on this broadcast.
Yeah, couldn't be further from the truth at all.
Yeah, I know.
And, like, you can still obtain a lot of the weapons over here if you live out on property.
Sure.
And, like,
yeah, there's a thriving underground in weapons, too.
Yeah, you better believe it. But, I hear a lot of these, you know, a lot of these people which they get on as experts on these networks, and it sounds like they just sat down in front of the internet and printed up documents and things, and then they sell them.
That's what they do.
And that's their research?
They don't do any research.
Instead of actually going to a library?
They don't do any research. Alex Jones is a broadcaster. He does not do research. Most of them don't do any research. I'd say 99% of them don't do any research. I do research.
Like, I've watched Alex Jones' video.
Uh-huh.
I think it's quite a good video.
Yeah.
A lot of the stuff that's in it.
Uh-huh. But is it all true?
Well, there's one part where he's interviewing a police chief.
Uh-huh.
And the police chief says a bullet nearly went through a window and nearly went into a restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
And then later on in the same video, Alex is saying that the video went into the restaurant, which is very interesting.
Yeah.
Because that's a very obvious sort of mistake to make.
Uh-huh.
Which helps discredit the whole thing.
Yeah.
And, like, yeah, asking questions to put words in people's mouths and things like that.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate, because I think Alex is genuine with where he's coming from.
Well, I would certainly hope so. He's got an excellent radio persona. He's obviously a smart young man. He is a young man. And if he'd just get on the research trail and not allow anything to go out over his radio broadcast that wasn't true and that, you know, that was a rumor, and wouldn't allow callers to call in and spread rumor and then pick up on it himself and do things like he did New Year's Eve, he would be probably one of the best Patriot broadcasters that there ever was. But
yeah.
You think he's going to do that? No.
I doubt it.
Because you know why? He cares more about how many people are listening than he does about what he's saying over that microphone.
Yeah.
Guaranteed.
The unfortunate thing, I think, is that if the Patriot community really did document everything, that'd be formidable.
Absolutely. That's what I've tried to do over the years. And I've done it. I have done it. And I'm the only one so far who has ever done it.
Yeah, well, I'm listening to you on the internet today. And it's very lucky out of this country to get your show on the internet, because the short wave signal doesn't reach you.
It took a long time.
I've been listening to you probably for about 3 years now. It's through people putting it up on the internet. And you used to be able to get it over the short wave a little bit.
Well, you know, we used to be on satellite. We used to be on some of the most powerful short wave stations in the world. But for various reasons, mainly because I do document and prove what I say, we were forced to leave every one of them.
Yeah. On a side note, I'd just like to mention something.
Mm-hmm.
I live in Canberra, the capital of Australia,
Canberra. Hurry up, we're out of time.
Okay, sorry, Bill.
I got to leave right now.
All right.
Thanks for calling.
God bless you. Thank you.
You too. Thanks, folks. Good night. God bless each and every single one of you. Start thinking. Stop listening. Start thinking. Stop listening. Good night, Annie Clune Allison. I love you very, very, very much.
Be my home or so, and dance.
dance me to the end of love. Let me see your beauty when the witnesses are gone. Let me feel your movement like they do.